This story touched my heart in a way I was not ready for. Let's look at this video real quick, and then I will be right back.
Special shout out to Black women. I've often been credited with, you know, having these grand ideas of people like, oh, Trevor, you're so smart and you're so, and then I'm like, who do you think teaches me? You know, who do you think has shaped me, nourished me, informed me? You know, from my mom, my grand, you know, my aunt, all these Black women in my life. But then in America as well, I always tell people, if you truly want to learn about America, talk to Black women. Yeah, because unlike everybody else, Black women cannot afford to f around and find out. Black people understand how hard it is when things go bad, especially in America, but any place where Black people exist, whether it's Brazil, whether it's South Africa, wherever it is, when things go bad, Black people know that it gets worse for them. But Black women in particular, they know what shit is, genuinely. People always be shocked. They'll be like, why do Black women turn out the way they do in America? Why do they vote the way? Yeah, because they know what happens if things do not go the way it should. They cannot afford to f around and find out. Yeah, man, I'll tell you now, do yourself a favor. You truly want to know what to do or how to do it, or maybe the best way or the most equitable way? Talk to Black women. They're a lot of the reason that I'm here. And so I'm grateful to them. I'm grateful to every single one of you. This has been an honor. Thank you.
Woo-wee. Listen, I ain't going to hold y'all. That thing had me in tears. Thank you, Black women, for all you have done, not just for me, but let's be honest, y'all. Let's be honest. What you've done for this country, they have this innate ability to carry to their own harm. I often have to tell Black women, put up your cape and put on your crown. Black women, listen to me. I'm not trying to push nobody away, but just listen to me, Black women. Put up your cape and put on your crown, queens. You deserve it. You deserve it. And I need to say this for the conversation at large, because I want to live in a world where I can praise Black women while not having to worry about offending white women or white people. Because to praise and to be proud of your heritage and where you come from and how and the contribution that the female of light color has given sacrificially to this country, it should not harm, it should not cause harm to anybody else. It shouldn't. Yesterday, my parents were in town and they were in a hotel, and I'm laying on the bed, and every time I'm around my parents, before I leave my parents, I ask them to pray for me. And oh boy, I'm about to get emotional. Hold on. Not live, Vincent. Not lie. But I understand why Trevor Noah got emotional, because, okay, come on. Because my mother has, okay, maybe I'm not ready for this right now. Hold on a second. Whew. My mother has a lot of things. I can't do this right now. Woo-wee. My mother, a lot of things has happened to me that has changed my life behind the scenes. And I went from making six figures a month to making just enough to get by. And every month, my mom sends me my car payment. And my parents are such a blessing to me, but I'm talking about Black women right now. And last night, my parents know the amount of pressure I'm under. And I laid on the hotel bed and my mom just prayed for 30 minutes, just praying and praying and praying. And I understand that a lot of people don't have that. And I'm so grateful for it because a Black woman is carrying me right now, like literally carrying me. And so that's why I got so emotional, because it's true. And Black women don't get enough credit, because I understand that that Black lady is not just affecting my world. She's carrying my sister and she's carrying my brother and my friends. My mom had a Christmas party for my friends on Tuesday. Why? Just because. And I know that's what Black women are doing all over the world. So I say to Black women, oh God, I can't believe this is messing up my brand. Hold on. I say to Black women, put up your cape and put on your crown, because y'all are queens, man. And I want this channel to be a channel where all people can, all people can enjoy. I don't want it just to be a Black channel or this channel, but I want to tell you that are watching this live and you that are watching this after the broadcast, whether it's this clip or the edited clip, if you do not like me sharing moments where I praise my people, this channel is not for you. But if you could just sit for a second, every once, I don't do it a lot, but every once in a while I just my people, I invite you, I love you, I want you. I want your expertise. I want to learn from you, because there's a lot I don't know. But I do need every once in a while to say thank you, Black women. And let me say also that I'm fortunate enough, because after my mom prayed, oh God, I'm going to get emotional again, my dad prayed. Woo, them people, I stand on their shoulders, man. I stand on their shoulders. And a young lady came to me. Y'all just bear with me as I just have this moment. A young lady came to me, and I think I told y'all about this day before yesterday or yesterday, talking about the absence of her father. And I was just really just talking to her and encouraging her. And she started crying. And it affected her so much, she talked to her friend, and then her friend came up to me today. And it's time that we stop being selfish. It's time that we stop being my foreign no more and let our light shine. It's time that we dust off yesterday's worries, and so that we can make room so the people coming behind us, the young kids and the young Generation Z coming behind us, can stand on our shoulders. So that's my spiel for today. Okay. All right.